Sorry.
I just thought it was a
talking about anger.
It was a lovely.
But it is, you can't, you know, it's tiny. See, that little tiny red number tells you how hot the plate is.
So
and
when
periodically,
I...
whenever, because it only operates when the pan is on it, if you move the pan, it then nudges the off button.
Oh, it doesn't stay on.
No. So you take that off and it'll go off. And then you try and put it on, you go, I can't see what number. You see my problem?
Yeah, I do.
In a nuclear war, you're going to block up...
What? A breakdown in society of any sort. It doesn't have to be nuclear. It could be...
I don't think you need to be blocking
a rampaging cold virus.
You need to get a rifle, don't you? Ward off mutant invaders.
Yeah, that's one of the things.
But you are better off than most in the quality of the thickness of your walls. And
yeah, probably.
So you'd survive the initial blast.
Well, yeah, all the zombie onslaught.
It wouldn't just be one bang, it would be thousands of them. And there was a map that just spins around, and all the targets are then highlighted with a red blob. And England has... 50 blobs. So it's not just GCHQ, it's bloody everywhere.
Yeah.
So wherever you are, whether you got fried the first time, you get fried the second time. And if you didn't get fried the second time, something would fall on your head soon after.
If I tried to speak to anybody, I had to shout at the top of my voice, you know, and then they couldn't hear, and then they answered, and I couldn't hear either, so it was largely less time. But it did mean that the next day, for about 3 hours, I had a wonderfully deep, dark brown, resonant voice. And I wish my voice was like that all the time.
Dreyer beers.
Oh, right. I think it's a wonderful asset, having deep... dark resonant command.
It's not currently very fashionable though in the voiceover world.
Really?
No, they're much more, I think people find it a bit cheesy, deep, rich brown voices. A lot of times male producers say, oh yeah, we want it really rich and deep. And then women will come in and go, oh, that is so cheesy. So sort of, yeah. I think men's ideas of what women would find sexy bear no relation to what women actually find.
Because it's an instrument,
I think
women
would find you sexy.
Can't you do
it? don't put yourself down. You know.
Especially in those trousers. Yeah.
I'm a fellow of the Royal Institution of Charles Surveyors, Tim. I'm not a mate. I'm not particularly your mate. Yeah. Don't call me mate.
Like mate, pal, mate. Mate is one of those words that skips a generation. So our parents' generation would have used the word mate. We didn't because they did. And because we didn't, the next generation does. There you are. Okay, oh, that's enough of that. You be quiet for a minute now. He's going to have a rest. Went into the bank week for us, and there's a lady in there who I've kind of known over the counter at Barclays for many years.
Trying out.
And I said, what do you do? She's an Indian lady. And I said, what are you doing this weekend? Anything good? And she said, I'm going to Brother's Day. I said, oh, what's that? And she said, if it's a day, it's like Mother's Day, but in the Hindu faith, you have Brother's Day. And it's on a Monday, and it's when all the siblings get together. And the siblings have a meal together. And I said, what a good idea. And I said, is there a Sister's Day? And she said, no, but there doesn't need to be. Of course, she's quite right, because it just means all the siblings sit together. So I think we ought to have the same sort of thing. Mother's Day, Father's Day, Siblings Day.
But Father's Day,
Jeffrey, just
I think I've got a lot of time for Sikhs. Yeah.
I mean, they wear great hats.
Yeah.
And when I used to live in Elm Bank, palatial residence, which, terrace pub. I'm finished.
Okay.
Lips moving, still talking. Right. And
the camera's got not. Oh, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
Go on.
Anyway, there was a Sikh wedding, and it was the most fantastically brilliant thing, because Elm Bank was a steep hill, and down this hill came this horse, preceded by people with gongs and everybody was dressed up like a good one, with turbans and frilly bits and stuff. And there were sort of male dancers all whizzing around in front of this big white horse with the groom on it. And then lots of other people, and there was sort of a drums and stuff and various instruments that I didn't recognise, and they went warble, warble. There was another horse with the bride on it, slightly smaller. The horse was the same size, the bride was slightly smaller than the bride. Yeah, it was really good. So I like, for that reason, I think Sikhs are cool. Yeah.
We went, I'm not really a great lover of parties, I must admit. I'd always go under sufferance. And
are you having a 65-year birthday party?
I don't know, I haven't thought about it. But anyway, we had to go to this party at Julius's. There's this one particular woman who I know from such gatherings, who was at this one, who really is dull as ditch water. The only interesting thing about her is that she had her arm ripped off in a car accident and it was sewn back on again, and it kind of doesn't work properly. But it's fascinating to watch. But anyway,
sew her the wrong way then?
Could you see?
Anyway, everybody was kind of, you know, talking a bit. When it came to her turn, I thought, oh God, you know, this is going to be definitely dull as it always is. And she said, we went to a wedding last week and the priest caught fire. And suddenly it turned into much better than I thought it was going to be. And it was a Greek Orthodox wedding at Whitcomb. Whitcomb used to be part of the Shirlington and Badgeworth parish, but the C of E sold it off to the Greek Orthodox people.
Small movie about making my shells, talking about it, and then displaying Cactus Bob on one of them.
Thank you, Tim. I have to say, I'm very, very upset because she said, God, I wish we had shells like that.
Send me a picture.
Yes, I'm going to. Absolutely.
I'm going to have to stop at that off at actual leisure on the way home and get myself a new pair.
Just ask if they've got a trouser expert who can
Hey.
You don't want to catch your hair, then, though, do you?
No. You haven't got any though, have you?
I have.
Oh, yeah, there's one.
well for you anyway, and the dog. So.
Stay there, Charlie. Stay there. Oh. Yes, I'll...